Hello friends and welcome back to my beautiful gardening life. And today I'm going to share with you this beautiful plant. It belongs to the bromeliad family. Of course, it has a name to itself. The name of this plant is a bilbergia plant. It also has another specification. It's called as a bilbergia pyramidalis. And I'm going to share with you in this video the different stages of this flower. It's also called as the flaming torch because, as you can see, it does resemble a torch, and it kind of evolves out from this beautiful setting or rosette setting of this lovely slender green leaves. So I have captured the growth of this flower or how it's blooming for last couple of days, and I'm going to share with you in this video. As this flower opens up, it leaves behind its petal and it kind of pushes forth this beautiful spectrum of colors. Here, if you just notice, this is like the third day since it has like evolved out from the rosette base. It is pushing out this matchstick kind of petals, you can say, from the center. Okay, and as we look at it, as it is growing in the next couple of days, I will share with you its care. So let me first start with its sunlight requirement. Now, this bromeliad plants are succulents. So as you know, succulents require bright direct sunlight. So this is a plant that requires this bright sunlight, and I have kept it in full sun. But right here I can mention to you that this plant can be also grown as a house plant, but with regard to the sunlight requirement, you will have to keep it next to a window which gets this indirect sun in and which would like just satisfy its requirement of direct sunlight. This is the next day. If you can see, these petals have just like opened and you can see a tinge of purpleness to the flowers. Now this purpleness act, or this purple matchstick heads actually acts as a source of attracting pollinators for the pollination process. If you look at this capture, you can easily see this purple flowers that have opened, which would be attracting the pollinators. This day is the fifth day since it has emerged from the base. And if you see, it is leaving out this orangish reddish color on this day. Okay, let us quickly move on to the watering process. Now this plant is a succulent, so you are going to water it only when the topmost layer goes dry, and you have to be careful here when I'm saying it, that when you water, water tends to stay at the base of the rosette. Now this is when, you know, this plant likes to grow in extremely sunny area, and it may be that it will not get water for a long time. So what it does, it stores water at the base of the rosette. Now when we have it in our garden, we tend to water almost like every second or a third day. Now over here, I'm telling this out of experience, that in case you do not tilt the vase and throw out the accumulated water, then it will lead to rottening of the base, which slowly trickles down to the base of the plant, to the roots, and the plant dies. I have lost a plant like this. I had another bromeliad which had this kind of variations towards the border of the leaves, and I forgot to tilt it. So the water remained in that rosette and the entire leaves like just got spoiled. This is a very important point regarding water, which has to be kept in mind. Now, moving on to the propagation, this plant is a monocarpic plant, means once it gives flowers, it will never flower again, or it may die. But it does give pups like this besides it, which can be easily separated and transferred to a new pot, or you could keep it as clumps around the same pot itself. Doesn't matter, it looks more beautiful when you have 2-3 blooming torches from the same pot. Now this is a capture that I have done today just before compiling this video. It is a tough, adaptable and easy to grow plant, and it is also found to be a good air purifier and also scientifically tested to absorb radiation. So you can really consider adding it to your garden, because this is like a flaming torch of beautiful colors in a garden of green. Thank you so much for watching. I see you in the next